Good morning, everyone. I feel very honored to welcome our speaker today, Mr. Asif, CEO, Chief Executive Officer, Princeton Smart Engineers, New Delhi. I thank our head of the department, Dr. R. Kumuda Madam, for organizing this program. And I welcome all students and faculty members who shown keen interest in this technical talk on scope of plumbing design for civil engineers. The whole objective of this technical talk is to understand the objectives and opportunities in plumbing design among students and faculty members of civil engineering department. Now I would like to introduce our speaker, Mr. Asif, CEO, Princeton Smart Engineers, New Delhi. Sir has a total work experience of 10 years in the field of MEP design. Sir is currently working as MEP engineer in FIFA World Cup 2022 stadium project, Qatar. Sir has worked in many projects, such as a maintenance engineer at Karnataka Bhavan, New Delhi, design engineer at Techni Engineers Private Limited, New Delhi, purchase and procurement engineer at KMG Autos Private Limited, Noida. Without further delay, I would like to request our speaker to handle the session. Over to you, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you for the introduction, sir. Thank you, Vijay, sir.
Thank you.
And good morning, everyone. So first, I need to show my screen. So good morning, everyone. Can anyone message me in chat box? My voice is audible and you are able to see my screen. Now I will share my screen. There is a chat box. You can message in the chat box. Okay, very good morning, Baba French. So my voice is audible and you are able to see my screen. Can anyone?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Audible, sir. We can able to see, sir.
Okay, fine. So guys, my name is Asif and I'm MEP engineer. MEP stands for mechanical, electrical and plumbing. So before starting this webinar, I'd like to tell you about the agenda of this webinar and why I'm giving you this webinar and all the things and what we're going to talk today. Fine. So guys, this webinar is not about deep technical things. I'm not here to teach you the technical things or calculation, but what I'm going to do here, I'll share my experience and I'll share the project, what type of project we do in our company. And after your civil engineering, what will be your job role in construction industry if you're working with MEP engineer and how plumbing engineers are working, right? And what all softwares we are using in this industry, those things I'll explain you. And so before starting this webinar, I'd like to tell you, as I told you, my name is Asif and I'm MEP engineer. So MEP stands for Mechanical Electrical Plumbing. I was working in Doha, Qatar for the company UGL, United Group Limited. You can Google about this company. They do hire fresher also, all the mechanical, electrical and civil engineers, they can apply. It's an Australian-based company, but my project was in Qatar. Qatar is going to host FIFA World Cup in 2022. So I was working for that project. What happened? I got few ideas and I left job. I came here and I started this company. So basically what we do, we are MEP design consultant. We do mechanical, electrical, and plumbing design of infrastructure project. I mean, any mall, any airport, any railway station, any metro station, any hospitals, any university, any college, any school, any type of construction related or infrastructure related project, we do complete services. MEP designing services and installation. For installation, we don't do directly. We have few companies, they'll take care of the installation work. Fine. So why I'm giving you this webinar, second, someone is messaging me. No. So why I'm giving you this webinar, you know what happened? After coming back to India, even in Qatar also, what I realized that only 5% of my academic knowledge I am using in this company. So I was surprised that time, right? So I was thinking to start something, related to industry and academic system. I mean, how to minimize the gap, So what happened, after coming back to India, fortunately I got chance to meet IIM Bangalore people during some event. So what they taught me, the same lecture I am giving you here. So that taught me, if you have any plan, if you have any idea, so related to startup or related to anything, the first thing what you have to do, you have to understand ground level problem. You have to understand customer pain point. And if you have solution, if you have better solution, the customer, the society will give you more than 100 times of your expectation. For example, in market we have OYO, we have Ola, we have Zomato, we have Swiggy, we have Baiju. What kind of problem they are solving? Go and check in how many years they have achieved their turnover, right? And without having your own car, you can book within a minute car and you can travel any destination, right? With the help of Ola and Uber. So they are solving our problem. The same way, if you have any idea, if you have any plan, you need to understand customer pain point, right? So that taught me, why don't we start working with college, working with the students, if you have any plan to do something in industry and academic system, so that you will understand their problem. And we know that no core company want to visit our campus. This is the reality. So currently, we are working with 300 engineering college, and especially in Bangalore, it's almost 50 engineering college. So before COVID, I have that experience. We had a, a technical talk, seminar, and after COVID, now we are giving webinar. So I started working with engineering college. I started working with the students to understand their problem, so that I will be able to launch my new startup. So we are still working. Because of pandemic, we are not able to launch, but very soon we are going to launch our new startup. That new startup will be how to minimize the gap between, especially for core engineers and industry, right? So that's why I'm giving you this webinar, and I started working with engineering college. So guys, what happened, after coming back to India, I was more interested to do startup. But what happened, you have to do something to survive here, right? Then I thought that, why I can't start, something in my core industry. Then I started this consultancy business or designing company. But I was more interested to do something new. That's why I'm giving this webinar. That's why I started with engineering college, to understand their problem. And you know why no core company want to visit our campus? You need to understand. There are so many, consultant. There are so many training centers. There are so many companies in market. They are trying to minimize the gap between industry and academic system. But still, we can see the problem is there. The companies that are visiting our campus, almost 95% companies are related to IT background. Why? Do you think that there is no job for civil engineers? Do you think that there is no job for mechanical and electrical engineers? Guys, IT industry is growing, and with the help of IT only, because of IT only, now we can talk each other, right? Because of internet only, because of laptop, because of those things, right? So I'm not against IT industry, but what I'm gonna tell you here, definitely IT industry is growing, but we are the backbone of IT industry. This world cannot survive without mechanical, electrical, and civil engineers. Remember this. This world cannot survive without us. Can you imagine this world without electricity? Can you imagine this world without automobile sector? Can you imagine this world without buildings, infrastructure? Not at all. So it means there is a job, there is a requirement of mechanical, electrical, and civil engineers. But the problem is, we don't know what all profiles are available in market and what is the industry demand. And I'll share you my experience that being a designing consultant, once you will start your own designing company, I'll tell you, you will get chance to visit all the factories, all the manufacturing company of all the equipment related to plumbing, related to civil, electrical, related to mechanical. They'll invite you to visit their factory, to see their product, so that you can recommend their product to your upcoming project, right? So I got chance to visit so many factories in Gurgaon, Noida. What I have seen, 100 years, 200 years, 50 years old company, their turnover is 300 crore, 400 crore, 500 crore, right? So they are not like TCS guys. They are not like Baiju. So they will hire you in bulk, right? The TCS will come to your campus and they'll hire everyone, whether you are from civil background or from computer science background, right? But what is happening in core industry, what they want some skilled people. They don't have budget that they will hire you and they will train you for 3 months or 6 months. The reason I'll tell you, as I told you, the turnover is very low. Suppose I'm coming to your campus and I'm going to hire you. I'll hire you, right? You are a fresher. You don't know anything about industry. but you're good in academic. I'll hire you, I'll train you for 1 month, 2 months, and 3 months. After that, I'll try to get some work from you. But unfortunately, that time, if you're getting any another job, better job, you will run away. The loss for me, and I can't bear that loss. That's the problem. Every company, every core company, what they want some experience. But being a fresher, it's too difficult to get experience, right? So what you have to do during your engineering, you have to learn something related to industry. At least some basic knowledge should be there. If you really want core job, then definitely you will get chance to work in core industry. And you need to search that. Apart from your traditional, traditional job, like for example, mechanical engineers, they are stuck with the production and manufacturing. The civil engineers, they are thinking that I am a civil engineer, I have to visit site only, right? I will work on site, but not like that, guys. The civil engineers, they are also working online. Nowadays, after the pandemic situation, go and check with the people. 30 to 40% people, they are still working. Rest 60% are jobless. Ask them who is jobless. And ask them who is working now. 30 to 40% people, they are working online. How, when, where? Ask them. Google, meet them. Then you will get to know in which sector, in which industry they are working. So you need to change yourself. You need to learn according to the industry or according to the world. Because everything is now online, right? So civil engineers, they are also working online. Because we have some software, we can work in structural design, we can work as a plumbing design engineer, we can work as MEP design engineer, right? So I'll explain you about these things and how you can do a startup also in this industry. And I'll tell you a few profiles name also in Naukri.com, TimesJob, Shine.com, in any job portal. You know that not everybody will like that, write that we are looking for civil engineers directly or we are looking for mechanical engineers. Some profile name will be there. If you are aware about those profiles, then you can apply. Otherwise, you will think that this is not related to my civil department. Right. So those profile I'll explain you today. Fine. So guys, in construction industry, I'll not explain you the deep things here, but what I'll tell you one second. There is a one profile. You have to remember this profile. Whenever you'll find this in any job portal, you can apply blindly because civil, mechanical, electrical engineers, they're working in this sector. BMS engineer, building management system.
Excuse me, sir. Sorry to disturb, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, can you make it a slideshow?
Yeah.
On screen. Yeah.
Yeah, okay, sir. Fine. So BMS engineer, BMS is the profile, guys. Whenever you'll find in any job portal that we are looking for BMS engineers, you can apply blindly because we people are working in this sector. But mostly you will find these kind of job in abroad, but in India also you can find. Some MNCs they are using. So what is BMS? BMS is a computer-based controlling system. With the help of BMS, what we can do, we can control all the mechanical, electrical, and civil-related services in one room or in one building. We can reduce the cost, we can reduce the manpower, right? But there is no any organization that they will train you before your engineering. Only you can learn these things after joining the company. Fine. But remember, BMS is the profile where you can work as a civil engineer. Fine. So now come to MEP industry. So MEP means mechanical, electrical, and plumbing. You know, guys, nowadays, the civil engineers, they are learning complete MEP services. And electrical engineers, they are also learning complete MEP services. And mechanical, they are also learning complete MEP services. You know why? Because in market, we have more supply than demand. If I'll call, I need one civil engineer or mechanical engineer, more than 1,000 people will apply for that job. You know that scenario now, right? So what they are doing and the expectation from company, like suppose if one guy is there and he knows that how to do plumbing design, he's from civil background, he knows how to do the plumbing designing. And another one, he knows that how to do complete MEP design. So whom I'm going to hire you? Hire. Definitely I'll hire that guy who knows that how to do MEP design, because I'll think that I'll pay the same salary, but I'll get that he can do the electrical design also and he can work in mechanical sector also. And anyways, if you're working in construction industry, you have to work together, right? This is teamwork. And initially, your designation will be might be GET, Graduate Engineer Trainee. But after a few years of experience, you'll become manager. That time, you have to take care of that construction site. You cannot tell him that, I don't know about mechanical thing. I don't know about electrical things. I'm not telling you that you'll become expert. At least some basic knowledge should be there related to construction industry, right? Not related to production or manufacturing. I'm talking about construction industry. How mechanical engineers are working in construction industry. How electrical engineers are working in construction industry. Together, you have to work, right? So you should know that basic thing so that chances will be more to get core job or chances will be more to start your own company also, whether it's a designing company or construction company. Right. That's why the people or students, you know, after their graduation or in final years, they're learning MEP services or MEP designing. Fine. Come now. So in mechanical, we have major domain. The name of the in construction industry, name of the domain is HVAC. Even you know that, guys, you know, I have that experience that as I told you, I have visited so many campus, also the engineering campus, final semester students. The mechanical students, mechanical professors, they don't know what is HVAC. Simply, they know that HVAC means high voltage alternating current. But, you know, HVAC is the profile. HVAC is the domain where engineers are working. All the civil, all the electrical, and all the mechanical engineers are working in construction industry. HVAC means heating, ventilation, and air conditioning. Heating, ventilation, and air conditioning. What I will do here today, I will show you a few images. Why? Because so that you will understand that what will be your job role and how MEP engineers are working in construction industry. Because during the interview, they can ask you anything related to construction. They can ask you, right? So that's why I'll show you image so that you will you have to recall the things where you have seen. And what will be your work? Because, you know, guys, unfortunately, we are doing civil engineering, we are doing mechanical, we are doing electrical, we are doing computer science engineering, but we don't know what will be our job role, what will be our work, what all profiles are there in industry, right? Simply, we are doing engineering, and after that, we will look for job. If we are getting job, any type of job, we will join. And after 1-2 years of experience, then we will realize that I am not happy in this profile, right? Because as per my experience, I'm telling you, because I do work in as a HR also for my company, for other company also in Naukri.com, I do hire people. So what I have seen after 2-3 years of experience, people that they want to switch their job. Why? Because they are not happy in that profile. Initially, what happened? They were not aware what all profiles are there in industry. Simply, they were looking for job. After my engineering, I need to join job only. After joining, after 2 years of experience, then they realize that I don't like this profile. I'm not happy in this company. Right? That time, the new company will count you as a fresher. Right? So that if you understand before passing your engineering, before joining that company, what will happen according to your personality, you can choose the profile, you can choose the domain, you can choose the company so that you will be happy and your growth will be more, even company will grow fast. Even I'll tell you, a few professors, the new professors, like, you know, after M.Tech, after B.Tech, they will join engineering college as a teacher or as a lecturer, right? So they message me because I have contact. They message me, sir, I don't like this teaching profile. I want to go, I want to join industry. Why? Because after their engineering, they immediately join the company. Immediately they join college. That time, then they were thinking that, that I need only job. Then now they realize that I don't like teaching profile. So guys, if you like teaching profile, then you should join college. If you like designing profile, you should go for designing. So according to your personality, you should choose the profile so that you will be happy. That's why I'll show you a few image here and I'll explain you about the profile also. Fine. Because, you know, guys, no organizations are there in our college or in any industry or anyone is there. They can guide us before our engineering that what all profile are there and what type of work will be there in this industry, what type of project will be there in industry. If anyone is there, so it will be good for us. But unfortunately, there is no any organization to guide us. Fine. So come here. So in HVAC, in construction industry, definitely you have seen this somewhere, might be in your house, in your school, in college. Right. This is called split unit or indoor AC. You can call it indoor AC or a split unit. Brand name, it's blur here, but you can see Hitachi. Why I'm telling you brand name, the connection between design engineer and brand name, later I'll explain you. But see here, this is outdoor unit. This is not cooler. Even the mechanical engineers, they can't recognize that this is cooler or outdoor unit. This is outdoor unit. What you have to do, you have to connect this outdoor unit to this indoor unit. Then after you can run the air conditioned system. Here, he's the technician. What he's doing, he's fixing this outdoor unit. You can find somewhere as a wall mounted or somewhere on rooftop. Fine. So now see here, where you have seen in parking area, metro station, or might be in airport, hospitals. So this is called duct, guys. This is called duct. We have different type of duct. See here, you can cross check, visit, try to visit any mall, any hospital on rooftop. You can find this type of duct. Fine. So what we do in our industry, what we do in any designing company, how to design this duct? So we have a software. Name of the software is Duct Sizer. With the help of Duct Sizer, we can design this type of duct. Got it? With the help of Duct Sizer software, we can design this type of duct. Now come to here. This is called centralized air conditioned system. Mostly you can find in mall or IT park or in hospital or multinationals company, right? So this is called centralized air conditioned system. So what we do in our company, we have two methods to design this. The first method is manual method. Even manual method also, we have some formula. We have some, you know, we have some method. The name of the method is E20 method in manual method. And the second method, we have software method. And what is the name of the software is HAP, H-A-P. Remember the software name, guys. HAP, HAP is the software, American software, license version software. With the help of software, what we do heat load calculation. You know, guys, using software is very easy nowadays. You don't need to do any calculation or anything. What you have to do, you have to feed only data and you will get the result, right? So what we do in HAP software, we do heat load calculation. After doing the heat load calculation, we can find the TR value, right? After finding the TR value, I mean tons of refrigeration, after finding the TR value, you can decide what will be the size of air conditioned system and what will be the type of air conditioned system. Because in you know that in market, we have different type of air conditioned system. You have seen earlier the split unit, right? Indoor AC, you know that window AC is there. You know that VRF system, chill water system, centralized air conditioned system, different type of air conditioned systems are there. So how to decide? What will be the size? What will be the type according to the project, right? So once you'll do the calculation, once you'll use the HAP software, you can find the TR value. After finding the TR value, you will be able to decide the type and size of air conditioning system for the given project, whether the project is residential, commercial, or industrial. Got it? So I told you two software. One software is for duct designing, for this, the duct sizer software, and second for the air conditioning system, HAP software. Fine. Now, you know, guys, we need complete MEP services during the construction of mall, right? I mean, for mall project, for airport project, for hospital project, right? So it means there is a requirement of MEP engineer. There is a requirement of civil, mechanical, electrical engineers, right? Where we can work. Fine. So now, you know, before you guys are from civil background, so you should know that before construction of any type of project, as I told you, whether the project is your house, I mean residential, or any factories, or any mall, or any shopping complex, right? Any theater, what you need architectural drawing. Then after you can start the construction of that building, or then after you can start working for the other sector, right? So the actual drawing will be like this. This is the 1 BHK house. The actual drawing, actual project, I'll show you later, but you can see this is the 1 BHK house. You need this type of drawing, then after you can start construction of that project. And who will give you this drawing? Nowadays, civil engineers, they are also doing this, because in our company, we don't have architect, civil engineers, they are capable to do this. But, you know, there is a course in university, Bachelor of Architect, 5 years course, the Bachelor of Architect. So architect, the person. They can plan these type of architectural drawing. They can plan, they can prepare the drawing, right? See here. This is the project flow in our company or in any designing company. So I'll explain you in this project flow, how we people are working and what will be your job role if you're working in any designing company or designing consultant. Suppose someone is a client here and what he want to construct his own hospital. So client, what he will do, he will meet architect and he will tell him, I have 10,000 square feet area and I want to construct my own hospital. So architect, what he will do, he will prepare this type of architectural drawing. This is for 1 BHK house. Just imagine for hospital, it will be different. It will be G plus 5, G plus 2, G plus 10, right? So after showing the drawing, once client is happy with the drawing, so architect, what he will do, he will submit the drawing to designing consultant. And who is designing consultant? We people are working as a designing consultant. So in this designing consultant, now the job role of MEP engineer will start. So first, what we will do the air conditioning system design. What we will use? We will use HAP software, we will use duct sizer software, and we will do the designing. After the designing, we have to prepare BOQ. Might be in your college, you will have one subject, estimation costing, but our engineering, we call it BOQ, bill of quantity. BOQ is nothing, it's an Excel file. In that BOQ, we are going to mention what all equipment we will use and what will be the brand, what will be the size, what will be the price. Those things we will mention in that BOQ. Now, HVAC designing is over. Then after, we will coordinate with electrical engineer. So electrical engineer, what he will do for the project, he will do transformer sizing, he will do cable sizing, he will do lighting design. For lighting design, there is a software, name of the software is Relux. With the help of Relux software, we can do the lighting design. Got it? Then after plumbing part will come and you have to do the plumbing design, guys. What you have to do in plumbing design, you know that? Imagine about your house. Doing the plumbing, plumbing designing for your house is easy. But imagine for high-rise tower, imagine for mall, imagine for multinational company, imagine for metro station, for airport. The plumbing design is difficult. So we have one software in plumbing also. The name of the software is Pipe Sizer. Got it. Now the plumbing design is over. After designing the plumbing part, we have to prepare the BOQ for the plumbing department. Again, we have to mention same things, right? Now MEP designing is over. After the MEP design, we will submit the project to construction company or the contractor. And the construction company, what he will do, he will start construction of the project according to the design. See here, they are the site engineer. They will follow the design designed by MEP engineer in designing consultant. This is also teamwork, guys. Fine. So here you understood now from client to construction company and the job role of MEP engineer in the designing consultant. And what is the connection between manufacturer and the designing consultant? As I told you, being a design engineer, you will have that authority, you will have that power. You are going to select the brand name for the project. Suppose you are working for mall, suppose you are working for hospital, you know that what all equipment we are going to use. If you are a design engineer, you have that authority, you have that power. You are going to select the brand name. You are going to mention the brand name in BOQ. And you know that for each and every product, we have so many brand in market, right? For example, if you're going to select the air conditioning system, so how many brands are there in market? We have Hitachi, we have Samsung, we have Voltas, we have Blue Star. So how to select the brand? So all the manufacturing company, what they will do, they will send their sales and marketing engineer to you with their catalog. They will come to you, they will visit your office, they will request you, please sir, recommend my brand. So you will meet to all the brand name, all the sales and marketing engineer, you're going to negotiate with them. Then after you will mention the brand name in your bill of quantity. Got it? That's why we have good contact with all the manufacturing companies. So whenever they have any requirement, any opening, and they're aware that we are working with college and students, so they'll inform us and our teammate will post the same job in Facebook page. You can cross check if your seniors, if anybody is looking for job, you can cross check. You will get the email ID, you will get the website contact details, and you can apply for the job. Fine. So I hope you understood from client to construction industry how we people are working. Now I'll tell you in this domain, How many profiles we have? As I told you, in every domain we will have a profile. So according to your personality, you can choose the profile. So first profile will be here, design engineer, the plumbing design engineer, right? So what you have to do in plumbing, what all codes and standards you have to follow, I'll explain you. But the first profile is here, designing, and designing is the core for all the profile, guys. If you have designing knowledge, your value will be more. And anyways, you have to use the designing skills in every sector. And I'll tell you one more important point. Once you'll join any company, you know, in your college, you know that department is there, right? Account department is there, civil department, mechanical department. It's the same way in engineering company, some departments are there. Like account department is there, procurement department is there, right? And one department, engineering department is there. So engineering department means designing. Got it? So designing, engineering means designing. So designing is very important for all the sector, for all the profile. So you should have the designing knowledge, and it's very important. It will help you in every profile. So second profile after the designing, we need someone who can do the installation work during the construction of the project. So the second profile will be site engineer. Got it? And after the installation, now building is ready, now mall is ready, now hospital is ready. We need someone from civil background, from mechanical background, from electrical background, who can do the maintenance work. So the profile name will be maintenance engineer. And now we have sales and marketing engineer. And guys, there is a rumor, and I don't know why students, they don't want to join sales and marketing engineer, because we have more job opening in this profile. And you know, we are also suffering. 10 to 15 days back also, we had a two requirement for Bangalore location, right? But students, what they call us, sir, can we get technical job? What do you mean by technical job? Sales and marketing job is also related to technical, guys. We are not selling here Surf Excel. We are going to sell here civil related equipment. We are going to sell here plumbing, mechanical, electrical related product. We need BTEC engineer who can understand that the specification of product, who can technically negotiate, right? So we need engineers. It's a core technical profile. And cross check Google, who is getting more salary? Right. And we have more job opening in this profile. So you can join this profile also, sales and marketing engineer. And fifth profile here, we have purchase and procurement engineer. Very few people are aware that this profile is related to our domain. So guys, imagine if you have your own construction company, then definitely you need someone who can buy all the material related to civil, mechanical and electrical. So you need engineer. So the profile name will be purchase and procurement engineer. So guys, according to your personality, if you want to work like IT engineer, if you want to work in air conditioned room with your laptop, then I'll suggest you to go for the designing profile. And if you want to start your own construction company after a few years of experience, then I'll suggest you to go for site engineering job profile. You will get chance to meet builder, architect, supervisor, technician, labor. Easily you can start your own construction company. Got it? And if you love to meet new people, if you want to visit all over India, all over world, then I'll suggest you to go for sales and marketing job profile or purchase and procurement job profile. So guys, according to your personality, you can choose the profile so that you will be happy in that company, in that profile. Later, you don't need to regret. Fine. I hope you understood about this profile also. And guys, if you want to start your own designing firm, you know that whenever we are talking about startup, especially the mechanical and civil engineers, they are thinking that we need huge infrastructure, more money. Then after we can do a startup, right? But guys, in this sector, without any investment, you can do startup. You can have your own company. What you need only skills. Skills means how to design any building. The complete MEP design, you should know that. If you really want to start your own company, complete MEP design you have to learn. If you have that skills, what you can do? You need one laptop, internet connection, and you should have good contact with builder and architect. If you have contact, they will give you the plan, they will give you the project, they will send you over the email, you will receive that, you have to do the calculation, you will prepare the BOQ, and you will send him, you will get money. So what is the investment here? No need to register your own company also. Initially, you can start as a freelance design engineer from your house, from your room. Later, once you will get more project, then you can register your company. You can hire a few more people. Got it? Like that, you can have your own designing consultant. Fine. So now, As I told you, plumbing design. Just imagine about high-rise tower. How to do the plumbing design? What all things we have, right? How to do the overhead tank calculation? You know that we have overhead tank, we have underground tank, right? We have to do the pump sizing also. How you are going to calculate that? How you will decide the number of people? What is the water requirement for the building? See here, there are some codes and standards during the design you have to follow. If you are doing electrical design or if you are from electrical background, you have to follow National Building Code. This is common for everyone. And if you are doing HVAC design, you have to follow ASHRAE, right? And if you are doing plumbing design, you have to follow IPC, NPC, and UPC. International Plumbing Code. What is this? You know, guys, just imagine. I'll show you here. One second. I'll show you the project, then after I'll explain. Share. See here. I hope you are able to see this. This is furniture plan, guys. This is the actual project. Actually, we have completed this project. But what happened? For client, we have completed this project. But students, they are working in this project now. All the intern in our company, they are working for this project. This is school building, guys, from client side. See here. You will receive this type of project, the actual project. The building name you will find here. See here. Regional Training Center, Educational Building. Furniture layout plan, architect name will be here, civil structural design name will be here, electrical design name will be here, mechanical design name will be here, CAD by, I mean drafting, AutoCAD by name will be here. Got it? So this is the actual drawing. So this drawing is furniture plan. See here. The classroom is here. You know, if you have this furniture plan, then easily you can do the plumbing design. You can calculate, you can count the number of occupants, you can count the number of people in this classroom. You can count 1, 2, 3, 4, and you can multiply how many people are there in this classroom. You can multiply all the classroom. Then after you can calculate what will be the requirement of water. Got it? Because according to IPC, International Plumbing Code, according to IPC, the water requirement for a single person, for per day is 200 liter. Got it? According to IPC, you have to follow the norms, right? 200 liters. So what you can do, you can multiply 200 into, for example, if we have a 20 people here, 200 people here. So what you can do, 200 into 200, you will get that 40,000 liter requirement per day we need if you have this furniture plan, right? But if you don't have this furniture plan, then what we will do? That time you have to follow the thumb rule. According to thumb rule, what we can do, you know, one second. So according to thumb rule, 25 square feet per person, you can, as per the thumb rule, you can take 25 square feet per person, right? But if you are designing any residential building, that time you can't apply this thumb rule. Because the calculation will be different. That time you have to apply your common sense also. Got it? But if you have furniture plan, easily you can decide. And there are some rules also. As I told you, as per the IPC, 200 liter we need for a single day or per person. And when you are going to design the overhead tank or underground tank, what you have to do? You have to do maximum, the water storage capacity you have to consider 33% maximum for overhead tank and 67% for underground tank. I'm talking about maximum. So after calculation of the water requirement, how many flats you have, I mean how many floor we have, and each floor how many flats you have, and each flat how many people will be there, you have to calculate. Then after you can multiply with the 200 liter, then you will get the actual requirement. The storage capacity, then after you can design the overhead tank and underground tank, and you can go with the maximum and minimum also, right? Maximum is 67% for underground, and for overhead tank, it's a maximum 33%. Got it? So according to this rule, we can design the plumbing part, right? And about the pump also, just imagine without any calculation, without any designing, you will suggest your technician that we need 5 HP pump, we need 2 HP pump. You know that in market, the price will be different for 2 HP pump, for 5 HP pump. And while if you are a design engineer, you have to think about cost also. Because once you will prepare the BOQ, you have to submit your BOQ and all the designing documents to your client, and you have to explain, you have to give presentation also. They will ask you, because the other designing company, the other design engineers, if they are ready to solve this problem, or they are ready to design in minimum cost, right? Suppose if you are designing and in your BOQ, if the project cost is 1 crore and another guy or another company is ready to give him in 80 lakh, so definitely he will prefer that guy. So what you have to do while designing, you have to think about cost cutting also. Right, you can't suggest him blindly. You have to do the exact perfect calculation. You have to, after the calculation, you have to suggest him, we need 2 HP pump or 5 HP pump. Then after, you have to give him explanation also. Got it? And we have to do the sewage water treatment plant designing also, if you're working in plumbing sector, if you're working in MEP designing sector. Got it? Apart from this plumbing guys, apart from this MEP services, I mean mechanical, electrical and plumbing design, there is one more sector in the construction industry, and name of the sector is firefighting. Imagine where you have seen these equipment. See here, these are the equipment. Imagine, you know, in civil, mechanical, electrical, you don't need to imagine. Wherever you will visit, you will find all the equipment related to our branch, right? We are not computer science engineers that we are doing coding and we don't know what will be the result, right? In civil, mechanical, electrical, everywhere you can find these equipment. Firefighting, you have to design. So in firefighting also, we have some codes and standards. You know, we have to follow those codes and standards. The name of the codes is National Fire Protection Authority, NFPA. Here you can see in this plumbing, we have IPC, International Plumbing Code. Might be during the interview, they can ask you what all codes and standards we have to follow for firefighting, what all codes and standards we have to follow in plumbing. Then you have to tell him IPC, NPC, and UPC. For firefighting, it's a NFPA, National Fire Protection Authority. And you know, in firefighting designing also, there are a sprinkler system, there are a foam system, right? So just imagine if you are designing any office, if you are going to design, the server room will be there. So you cannot simply put the sprinkler system for server room, because you know in that server room, computer and other equipment will be there, right? So in sprinkler system, the water can damage the computer and the other equipment, right? So that time what you have to do, you have to design with foam-based system. So those things you will learn once you will start working on the real time project. Got it? So I hope you understood how we people are working and you have seen the project also. Now I'll show you the actual. One second. See here. The actual school building is like this, but once you are going to design the plumbing part, then you need furniture plan. Before plumbing part, you don't need furniture plan. You can design directly. See here, the actual plan will be like this, but you need both the plan, furniture plan and this plan also. Got it? See here, the classroom. So imagine guys, now you are a student, you are in final year, might be you are in second year, and now you can design this school building. If you know how to design this school building, how to do the plumbing design for this school, then definitely you can do for any mall, any hospital, or any shopping complex, right? And you can mention in your CV that you have real-time work experience in this project. So any company will be happy. And in your final year, before your graduation, you can start freelancing work. You can contact with some builder or some companies, some designing companies. You can ask them, you have that skill, you have knowledge, they will give you the freelance project and you can start learning and earning both the things, right? Because 10 days back, I have seen that in WhatsApp status. I remember 2 years back, we had a program in, there is a one college, Alliance University, 3 days program we had in that college. in electrical department. So one guy, now he's in final year, he started working as a freelance design engineer. I have seen his in my status, in WhatsApp status. He mentioned that I got second project. Then I asked him, how come you are in final year? How he started working as a freelance? Then he said that in 3 days, sir, I only learned that how to do the complete calculation of electrical designing for any type of building. So I'm getting a small project now. Just imagine he's in final year, he started working. So easily he can get job or he can start his own company after the engineering, right? The same way you can also do. So guys, you have to always focus that what is the industry demand and what all requirement is there, and you can learn before your graduation those things. Fine. So I hope you understood now. So now ma'am will explain you in detail. I mean, how to apply for the job, what all things you have to mention in your CV, right? And how to apply for the internship also, what all benefits you will get. Fine. So 1 second.
Audible, guys?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Okay. Good morning, all of you. So, myself Farheen, and I'm the co-founder of Princeton. So, today I'll be explaining you about the internship opportunity and how to find a job in the core field. And also, you can apply for how you can start applying for the jobs when you're still studying. So those things I'll be covering. And also I'll give you a quick background about Princeton. So you can just have a look at this like 3 or 4 slides, then I'll quickly go to the jobs part, okay? So Princeton was established in the year 2016. We started this company and collaborated with smart engineers. And the major services what we provide are MEP design, and mechanical, electrical construction, operation and maintenance, interior designing. So these are the various services we provide. Coming to the clients associated with our company are Honeywell, HCL, Park Plaza, Rashtrapati Bhavan, so in Delhi. Recently, we are tied up with a Qatar-based company called VidaTech. It's an international company, which will give us an international recognition for all our interns, those who are working, all mechanical, electrical and civil students who are working as interns in our company. We'll get a certificate of internship, which is internationally recognized by this company. Okay, so smart engineers will take care of maintenance work. IRA consultant will take care of all the designing work. So what do we do apart from our engineering services is we conduct corporate to campus connect programs like webinars, technical talks, conferences, workshops and internship programs we organize so that we can minimize the gap between fresher and industry. How many of you here agree with me that there is a huge gap between academics and industry? You can either raise your hand or you can say yes or no. Do you agree with me? Yes, Balakarthi has raised. Okay, Lalit has raised. So guys, fine. What can we do to minimize this gap? Can someone tell me what can we do to minimize this gap? You guys have to interact, guys. You can unmute and speak. I don't want you guys to simply sit idle. I won't be presenting just by looking into the slide. I want to give you maximum outputs. As much as knowledge I have, I want to deliver that to you. If you interact with me, I'll be able to give you more. What can we do to minimize this gap? Through internships. Very good, Nancy. And why AICT has made internship is mandatory because they want you to get some exposure to the industry. Internship is should not be just like, you know, one certificate and report which you have to submit to your college. It should not be only for that purpose. It should be for, you should understand the importance of internships, what AICT has made it. See, not only just that internship, so to minimize the gap, what we can do is we can get the students exposed to the industry people. We can make them interact with industry people so that they get to know exact what skill is required. See, I'll share you one of my personal experience, what I have gone through. I have visited more than 200 plus engineering colleges across Pan India, and we work in almost every state of India. And wherever I go, I see that, you know, there are very few core companies visiting campus for recruitment, especially talking about core mechanical, electrical, and civil students. I'm not talking about IT because we are in IT hub. I'm talking to you from Bangalore. I know that here there are a lot of IT companies, and almost every, even a third, you know, three-tier college, like a college which is very not that good in academics, also not that good rating also, even that college students, even CS students are getting placed, and they have almost 90-95% of the CS students are getting placements. But what about us? What about civil? What about electrical? What about okay, so what can we do to minimize this gap? How to get into the core companies is, see, I visited RV College of Engineering. It is considered one of the top college in Karnataka. I saw there one of the department, core mechanical and mechanical HOD. Somebody has muted. I don't know who it is. Okay. Anyways, so is there still a disturbance? Lalit, I think the voice is from your side. Sir, can you please ask them to mute?
Yes, ma'am.
Should I wait?
Just a minute.
Just remove him from the meeting, sir.
Sorry, the host has a problem. So host has the control to remove a person from meeting. I am calling Lalit ma'am. Just a minute.
Okay, he left the meeting, I guess. No problem. So where was I? Yeah, I told you that I met mechanical head of the department in RV College. I saw him sitting and learning Python course on his desktop. I asked him, sir, why are you learning Python? He told me, ma'am, what to do? We can't call CS department faculty every time to come and teach our students what is Java, what is C, what is C++, what is Python and all. So I told, why civil or mechanical students, why they should learn Python, why they should learn, you know, all these things, coding languages, if they have to go to, he told, like, no core companies are visiting campus. So we ultimately force our final year students, mechanical, civil, and electrical students to join IT company. I was really, really shocked because, you know, we are into core, we are into core services. We know that sometimes when there is a vacancy, we struggle to find a proper candidate. Okay. But company, excuse me. Yeah. But colleges are thinking that there are no jobs. We are struggling to find the appropriate candidates. A lot of core companies are struggling to find the appropriate. Like many of the design consultants we are currently working with, they call me that we have an immediate requirement for a design engineer. Fresher we need, but we need it immediately. But we never find that kind of, you know, sometimes we don't get the appropriate candidate. It's not like jobs are not available, guys. I'll tell you, if a head of the department, if they say that there is no job for mechanical, electrical, civil, if they force you to join IT companies, trust me, do not do that. Jobs are available because job satisfaction is also important, because we have spent 4 years in our engineering, in our core field. And after spending 4 years, if I ask a mechanical student or a civil student to sit in front of a laptop and do the coding, definitely he will not be liking it. Even if he joined the company because of the family pressure or from the college and the pressure is there. Later, 1 or 2 years later, he gets frustrated, he leaves the job, and he again starts his career as a fresher again in his civil field. So no need to do that, guys. I'll show you today how many requirements we have. So what you need to do is either you can search, like you have to search according to the profile. Okay, so before I explain you about that, let me just show you this. See, you can just have a look at the Princeton Gallery. So the almost 300 plus colleges with which currently we are tied up. So I cannot mention 300 college names here. I have just mentioned few of them. So now coming to the MEP field. Okay, so what is MEP? MEP means Mechanical, Electrical and Plumbing Design. We are not any training institute. We are a core engineering company. We do mechanical, electrical and plumbing designing for IT tech parks, malls, airports, all these things we design. And I'll show you our partner company, which is there in Qatar. First, I'll show you that. We are Tech Doha Qatar. You can also search. So this is our company in Qatar. So the projects, what kind of projects we are doing? When we started conducting the seminars and webinars and technical talks, this input came from the students only. Students only insisted me that, ma'am, you're organizing events, 1 hour talk or 2 hours webinars. You're giving information about what exactly the work is being conducted by your company. But how can we start working as an intern in your company? See, it's not easy to make you guys work offline in a company because we cannot accommodate such a huge number of students in our office. So we started an online internship program. See here, these kind of projects our engineers are doing: Rotana Towers, which is there in Qatar, and MKM Towers, school complex is there, Al Madin complex. So these kind of projects they are doing. So what we thought, we already have the design engineers. So we need not have to hire any training faculty or any professor or any teaching person for the training to be given to the students. We thought the same design engineer, we just requested them to spend some extra time out of their designing job and give you the exact training knowledge or exact designing knowledge so that you gain the exact industry exposure. This is the program what we have. So you need to understand, it's not the training given by any teaching faculties or professors from I'm not telling that professors do not have the knowledge. They have academic knowledge. But if you want an industry experience, if you want an industry-based internship, you need to be exposed to the industry people. That is my point. Okay. So these are the projects with which, and this company logo will be there in your certificate. So let me just show you the certificate also. Okay. So just yesterday I had given one certificate to your college student only. He is from Kaushik. Yeah, you can just have a look at this. So he is from Mechanical Department, SVC, and September 7th to October 7th, he has completed an internship in HVAC design, that is heat, ventilation and air condition designing. And this is the certificate what we have. You can just have a look at the certificate. See, this Qatar company logo will be there in your certificate. And for you, the topic will be plumbing design. Okay, instead of HVAC design here, you will have plumbing design as your topic. Okay, so you can just let me show you the job requirements now. Okay, so what you need to do is, see, if you want to apply, how many of you want to get placed in a core company? Raise your hand. How many of you want an offer letter from a core construction company? Vaishali, can you just put your video off, please? Okay, Naveen has raised, Hariharan has raised, Nancy has raised. What about others? Sujit has raised. See, 100 participants are there. I can see only 4 or 5 hands. All right. So can someone just unmute any one of you? Students, I want 1 or 2 students to just unmute yourself. Anybody?
Yes, ma'am.
What's your What's name, ma'am?
Nancy.
Am I audible? Audible?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm getting my voice.
You're audible, ma'am. Is my voice audible?
Yeah. Okay. Nancy, just tell me you are going to be a PR in my company.
Sorry, can you repeat it again? Sorry, ma'am. It's slightly breaking.
Yeah, it's going. I don't know why. Is it audible now?
Yes, ma'am. Loud and clear.
Okay. Fine. Say, suppose if you are a technical HR in my company, okay, and let me show you a project. Say this kind of a project, if I have taken from Dubai, and if I ask you to go to SVC Chennai campus, and I will be giving you two requirements for the company. We need two plumbing design engineer freshers for this company, or plumbing design engineer. So you can see here, this is a 30-story building apartment project. So it's the cost of this project is 30 crore. Okay, so you being a technical HR, you visit the campus for recruitment for hiring purpose. I give you a scenario here, Nancy. So just imagine if there are two people. One is Sridharan and there is one more person called Karan. Okay, so if these two are the candidates from SVC Chennai who are going for the interview, say Karan has already gained the knowledge in plumbing design and he know what is pipe sizing or how the plumbing system is designed, which are the softwares we use, how the project is documented, how the project is taken from the client, how we prepare the bill of quantity, what are the equipments need to be selected. All this idea Karan already has. He know how to prepare a report for the project. Complete idea he has. And the other person, that is Sridharan, okay, so he has only the academic knowledge. Whom do you want to call first into the interview round? Karan,
ma'am.
Okay. What happens in case he has Sridharan?
I have to train him, so it costs too much. Also, okay. It's a waste of time and employing some people to train him also.
Right.
All these considerations.
You are offering a package of 10 lakhs to Sridharan. How much will you be investing on him for a duration of six? Say 10 lakhs package means 50,000 per month if you are paying him. For a duration of 6 months, how much you have to invest on Sridharan?
Like at least two foot of the amount.
Say 50,000 into 6 months is how much? 3 lakhs. Right. So 3 lakhs if you invest on Sridharan, say you are offering 10 lakhs package now. Okay. So after 6 months of training, after spending 3 lakhs on him, then the time comes when he will be start giving you output to the company. He gets somewhere better offer. He gets some 15 lakhs or 20 lakhs package somewhere else. What will he do? Will he continue with you or he will leave your company?
It depends upon the employer attitude.
No,
some may stay.
Give you a package, 3 lakhs, okay, and somebody else is giving you 6 lakhs package. Will you join my company?
Probability of going out is more, ma'am.
Yeah, definitely. Somewhere is 10 lakhs. No, see, this is the problem with freshers. Actually, the problem is wherever we get the offer more, we go. So it's a normal thing, right? So everybody wants a higher package. So that is the reason why core companies are not hiring freshers, because freshers will be looking, they'll be searching for the jobs for the higher packages. And once they get the salary hike or somewhere else, so they leave the company. And we core companies, we are not like IT companies, guys. If you want, go and check in your, if you want to know the details of the placement records of IT companies, go and check in your placement department, how many students got placed in TCS or Infosys or Wipro or, you know, Tech Mahindra. You'll see 100, 150, 200 students. TCS hired 250, 270 students from your campus. You will see this huge number of list. The reason why they hire, because see, they have a huge training budget for training the freshers. But we core companies, we do not have such a huge training budget for hiring freshers and training them, then making them ready for the work and then start expecting the work from them. The core companies have a mindset that as soon as you join the company, hardly 1 week of training you get, hardly 1 week. Sometimes only 2 or 3 days of knowledge transfer sessions, KT session, we call it as KT sessions. Knowledge transfer sessions are given for 2 or 3 days. Fourth day, the manager will expect the work from you. You cannot say that I'm a fresher, I don't know this, I don't know that, I have not learned in academics. They will not accept it. They will just fire you out of the company if you do not have the exact. Even if you get placed in a core company, it's really, really hard to survive in the company, because if you are technically not strong, trust me, you will be fired out of the company as soon as you start showing that you do not have the exact skills. So what you need to do is, now if you are in your sixth semester or fifth semester or third semester, whichever year you are in, second year, third year or final year, you have to start your preparation from right now. It's never too late. You have to start immediately what exactly you're supposed to do, the steps which you are supposed to follow, that I will explain, so that you can get into the core companies. Okay, steps to get into core companies. Okay, so what is the first step? You have to do an internship, or you have to gain skills according to the industry demand. Gain skills. Don't do some internships which are not, you know, the topics which are not even used in industry. Gain skills according to the industry demand. Okay, you're able to see my PPT, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So after gaining the skills, what you need to do is start your CV preparation, CV or resume preparation. I'll explain each and every point clearly, how you have to prepare your resume. All that also I will explain. Okay, start your resume preparation. Because even if you are in second year, you should keep your resume ready, because you can start applying, you can start doing part-time work. I have a lot of students who are currently doing part-time work with many of the companies. They're earning, even though if they are in second semester or fourth semester, they have started earning, they have started learning, they have started gaining the industry experience. How you can also do that, I'll explain. After you start preparing your resume, make a list of core companies related to your skills. List of companies related to your profile. Okay, so once you start making the list of companies, start mailing your CVs to them. Start mailing or start approaching them. How to approach that, each and every point I will explain clearly. I'm just mentioning the points. So once you start approaching them, you will start getting a reply from them, or they will schedule an interview. Start attending the interviews. Whether it can be online interviews or offline interviews, you can start attending it. Somebody has again unmuted. I don't know who it is. Sir, can you please just have a check? Prasad. Okay. Start attending interviews, then start taking freelance or start taking part-time projects from them. Part-time projects. Don't join as a full-time employee. Start taking part-time projects or start doing freelancing. How to do that, I'll explain. So then you are building a bond with the companies, so you will start getting offer letters. By the time you pass your engineering, you'll start getting offer letters from these companies with which you're doing a part-time work. Okay, start getting offer letters from the core companies. So how you have to start this? So let me just explain you the first point. This is the internship, right? So how you can gain the internship or the exact skills. We have an internship program that is plumbing design internship, wherein you get a certificate of internship from internationally recognized company. Second thing is you're going to get a live commercial project. Here you will be designing a project it's not a dummy project, it's a client project. Client project, what we have completed for our client. Same project will be assigned to the students. You'll be working here for a duration of 1 month from September, for a duration of 1 month, 1 month duration, August to September, you can mention. So for a duration of 1 month, you'll be working. Okay. And it's going to be like study materials and data books, everything will be provided to you so that when you're later on, if you want to revise or any of the concepts, if you want to practice it again, or when you're doing the projects with the companies, when you start doing freelancing, you will require these data books so that we will share it so that you can keep it later on also. And the sessions are going to be on Zoom platform. Timings for the session is 8 to 9 p.m. Why we have chosen 8 to 9 p.m.? Because we have our industry people working from morning 9 to 7, 9 to 6:30. So after 7, at least 1 hour break they need so that they can give you the delivery should be the content delivery should be like their mind should have some rest also, right? 8 to 9 p.m. they'll be free in the evening after their work hours. So they will be delivering you, the design engineers. Who will be delivering? MEP engineers. MEP engineer, or you can call it as design engineers. Okay. So we have Mr. Imtiaz. He has 10 years experience. He was in Qatar also. He has experience from Qatar as well, and he'll be training you, he'll be giving you the live sessions on Zoom platform. The sessions will be live plus recorded. Recorded why? Because suppose after completion of your internship or 1 or 2 days if you have not attended the class, maybe you had network issue. Many students are in rural areas. They do not get the proper network. So we record the sessions and we share that recording also so that if you have missed any of the class, you can cope up with the help of recordings. Or if you want to practice the sessions again, you can do it using the recorded sessions. So this is related to the internship. Okay, now certificate, project, study materials. There is one software called Pipe Sizer, which we use in industry for pipe design. Okay, Pipe Sizer. This you will be getting, this software also, and also we will be training you manual method also, because in India, if you join any core company, if you are joining as a plumbing design engineer in India for any construction company, they will go with the manual method. If you are joining in Dubai, Singapore, or any foreign countries, they'll go with a software method. So you should know both. You should know manual method also. You should know software method also. Both we will give you. Now coming to the second point, that is start your CV preparation, right? So start how to prepare your resume, that I'll show you now. So let me just show you the resume of a senior employee. You should prepare your resume like an expert. Do not prepare your resume like a fresher, because when you are applying for a company, core company, they will not entertain a fresher CV. So make sure your resume should be like a experienced person. Even though if you are a fresher, at least show some internship experience. So how you are going to prepare your resume? See, first, let me consider Nancy will prepare her resume. She'll mention her name, her address, and her email ID. And here you can write presenting 1 month of experience in plumbing design and MEP services. And you have done any, whichever project you have done, the project title you can mention here. Okay. So next you can mention the contents which you will be learning in the plumbing design internship. So let me just share you the contents of the plumbing. Give me a second, it's loading. Okay, where I was, yeah. So let it load, till then I'll just explain you these things. Okay, yeah. So in this contents, what you have to write, that I'll share it. Here you'll be mentioning as internship experience summary. You will not write as experience summary because you're still a fresher. So you can mention internship experience summary. Here you need not have to write. He is a mechanical engineer, so he has written HVAC designing. So as I told you, in MEP, mechanical part is taken by, the mechanical is HVAC, heat, ventilation, air condition designing. Electrical part is taken care by electrical engineer. Plumbing part is taken care by civil engineer. Okay, so you can write as plumbing design engineer intern at Princeton Smart Engineers Bangalore from August to September. Like this, you can mention at least one company experience you can show. In this professional synopsis, completely you're going to copy and paste the entire stuff. Okay, so one second. Let me share you the contents of the plumbing internship. Yeah, so these are the contents. So before that, let me give you the plumbing group link. So this is a 8 p.m. batch, which is currently going on. So you can also join in this group, and let me just share you the link. Where is it? Yeah. Click the link in the chat box. You'll be able to join the group. I'll share you the contents of this internship once you join the group. I'll share you this PDF. Okay, those who have joined late, you can take the PDF from your friends, those who have joined here. So I'll just share the group link also here. So you can share it with the people, those who have not joined yet. Or once all of you join, I'll reshare the PDF, don't worry. Okay, so that you can read later on. So now coming to the syllabus, what you're going to do is, so the entire PDF here, whatever is there up to STP design. So this complete thing you're going to, it is mentioned in a point wise. You can mention it like a paragraph the way he has mentioned here. So the entire stuff, what you learned in the internship, you are going to copy and paste it here. Do not write in your professional synopsis or in your resume that I'm a good badminton player, carom competition player. No, guys, please do not write that. No core company will entertain you. If you prepare your resume, if you do not focus on your resume preparation properly, it is going to be really hard for you to get into the core companies. Okay. So once you complete this, once you're going to copy and paste everything what you learned in the plumbing internship here. So if you prepare the resume the way I told you, trust me, you will get reply from the core companies once you start mailing your CV. Okay, in the software skills, you can mention, see here, he has mentioned pipe design software. You can also mention that pipe design software, which we will be giving you. We'll give you a student version, which you can use it later on also. Okay, and in interpersonal skills, right, you are a good communication, you have good communication skills, team building skills, whatever you want, you can mention. Project handle, at least one project. See here, he has mentioned 20-25 projects, so many projects he has mentioned. So you can mention at least one project. What is the project? You'll be designing any 1-2 BHK flat or 3 BHK building, 3 BHK apartment, or whichever the project which you're going to do in this internship, mention that. And also mention at Bangalore, Princeton Smart Engineers, I have done this project. So once you prepare your resume like this, and your personal particulars and your education background, you can mention. Once your CV is ready, next what you need to do is start searching the companies. So make a list of the companies. How to search the companies is you have to search MEP design consultants in Bangalore or Chennai. You can search in India also. You can search in India, more than 2000 you will find. If you just search in Chennai, many of the companies are in Chennai and Hyderabad. In Bangalore, I find very less companies. So let me just go to Just Dial. You can go to Just Dial and make a list of these companies. You can see here all these companies are there. So what you need to do is you have to prepare an Excel sheet. This has to be done from your end. Okay. So if you start doing this, you will understand how many companies are working and where you can apply for the jobs. So you cannot directly give them a call and ask, sir, do you have a job? Okay. So you have to, let me just show you, I have prepared the list. So this I have prepared for Bangalore location. Let me just see here. So serial number of the company, name of the company, email ID, contact number, location, and follow. You can mention like this. Callsign Global is the company. So let me show you for the Bangalore location the way I have searched. The similar way you can do it for Chennai. Okay. See, so you just click on one company, go to their website. Okay, so the name of the company is Callsign Global. So that I have just copied and have pasted here, Callsign Global. And email ID of the company, that you can find it on the website. Where is it? Here. Go to contact us page. You can find the website. See here. So this you will copy email ID and you will paste it here. And contact number of the company, you can see here this company contact number is there, that you will copy and you will paste it in your Excel sheet. And the location of the company is Bangalore, near Banjankri the company is located. And follow up, whether you have mailed the CV or not, that you can mention. And there is one more company called Capital Engineering Consultancy. Let me just search Capital. So I had just opened this company details also. So this is one of the company which is based in Dubai. Basically they have, see here, Dubai number is there. So they have in Dubai, Abu Dhabi, London, and they have in Oman, Iraq, and every place they have. So in Chennai also they have in this particular location. So this is the address what they have. So directly don't give them a call and ask if you have a job. So you have to copy and paste your number and also the email ID of that company. So where will you find the email ID? Here you can find the email ID. So in this way you prepare the complete list for 200. If there are more than 200 companies in Chennai, definitely you will find minimum 400 to 500 companies, MEP design consultants. This is what you are supposed to search. You cannot simply search core construction company. You have to search MEP design consultant, because you are going to do an internship in plumbing. You should search the companies related to your profile only. Okay, so say suppose you have prepared a list of 200 companies. What you need to do, you need to copy the entire email IDs, whichever you have prepared, and start mailing your CV to the companies. How you are going to mail? You'll just write, "Dear sir, I'm excited to work as a plumbing design engineer position in your company as a part-time engineer. Please clearly mention in your CV that I want to work as a part-time engineer." Why? I'll tell you. See, no core company will have every time, we will not have every company will not have a full-time requirement every time. Okay, so but part-time requirement will be there almost every time. Say why? Because I'll tell you. Say suppose if this month, say Callsign Global, okay, so this company has say 15 employees next month, if and 15 projects they have for the month of August. September month they are getting say 20 projects. Okay, so they will not be hiring extra 5 engineers only for the month of September, because maybe in the month of October they may not get 20 projects, they may get 15 projects again. So what will they do with the extra 5 employees? So they cannot make the employees implicit and take the salary, right? So they'll be looking for some part-time or freelance engineers who can do the project for them in minimum cost. So what you guys can do is you can write in your resume or write in your mail that we are looking for a part-time position or a freelance position. Make a team. Instead of mailing your CV individually, make a team of 4 to 5 people. Here, how many people are there? Prasad is there, Sridharan is there, and you can see Logeshwari, Nancy is there. So in this way, you can make a team. Mention in the resume, in your mail, that we are a team of 4 people, we are a team of 5 people, we are ready to work on the projects. And whichever project, say here, the school building project, I think sir has already shown you. This is for this complete project. Our students have completely designed this complete project. Say, suppose if I teach you how to do the designing for one classroom, can't you design for the next room? Definitely you can design. In this way, your whatever project which you have, which you will be completing here, mail that project, attach that project file also in your mail, that you have already completed this project at Princeton Smart Engineers Bangalore. As if you show that you have work, you have an internship experience on in a designing firm, definitely they will show some interest in your CV. Okay, and mention that, sir, we are ready to work for free. Do not write that I'm looking for some salary or anything. Okay. Tell them we are ready to work for free. We want to gain some experience in your company. If you have any opportunities, please give us. Please schedule an interview for us. Take the interview. If you in the interview, guys, they'll not ask you any big questions. Okay. When you're going for interviews, right? They'll not ask you to design any plumbing system for this kind of mall or airport or hospital. They'll not give you. They'll give you some small buildings like this, some 2 BHK, 3 BHK flat. They'll give you. They'll ask you, do the plumbing system design for this 2 BHK flat and show me. If you have already designed a building here, if you've already completed a project in your internship, this 2 BHK flat is like nothing for you. You can easily do it and show them. So if you're able to clear an interview, so definitely they'll give you small, don't take bigger projects, okay? Don't take projects, when you start taking project, don't take mall or airport or big, big projects like IT tech parks. Don't take such projects from them. Take small, small projects. So what kind of projects you will take? Say, let me consider. If you have applied for Wences and Colson and Mecca project engineers, say, suppose you have cleared interview for these two companies, Wences and Colson Global. August to September, now September month, you'll be doing your internship. Say October, you start preparing your list of companies. And in the month of November, say you start getting your responses to your email that you have mailed your CV. So from December, if you start taking the project, okay, say one project you have taken for Wences, you have taken one residential two-story building project, say this kind of project. Nancy and Sridharan has taken. Nancy will do the ground floor part, and Sridharan will do the first floor part. You complete the design, you mail the project to the company HR. They'll be really happy that they got the project done for free of cost. So in this way, you're building a bond with Wences. Say in the month of January, you take one project, one residential apartment project you take, four-story apartment, make a team. If you have four people in a team who are there, let me just see the participants list here. So, Avinash is there, Ajay is there, Anant Raj is there, and Arun is there, okay? So four people can do one residential apartment project, okay? So on this kind of residential apartment, I think apartment is not there. So let me just show you. Say this is, do not consider this building, say four-story apartment is there, okay? So ground floor, one person will do, second floor, another person will do. In this way, if you have completed the project and you start mailing that project to the company HR, they'll be really happy that you completed the project for them without paying. They are not paying you anything, right? So you're just working for free to gain the experience. So suppose you've completed two projects, one for Wences, one for Colson Global. Third project you're doing, say suppose for hotel consultancy. Okay, so you start mentioning those project list in your resume, start upgrading your resume. So first project done at Princeton, second project at Colson Global, third project you've done for Wences, fourth project on hotel consultancy. So once your resume is full with 10 to 15 projects, okay, don't take more than one project per month, because you have your academics also. That academic should not get disturbed. 9 to 4, if you have your college hours, after 4:30 or 5 o'clock, 5 to 8, 5 to 9, you can work extra time to gain your experience, industry experience. So once your CV is full with 10 to 15 projects, tell these companies, sir, I'm going to pass. So these companies only will know, they will only ask you, okay, Nancy, when are you going to pass out? 2022 June. Okay, we have a requirement for a plumbing engineer. You are associated with us for more than 1 year. If you have started working in second semester, by the time you pass your engineering, you can show 2 years of work experience to the companies. Right. So if you are in third year, you can show 1 year experience. If you are in final year, at least 1 month, 2 months, 3 months experience you can show. So Wences Engineering Services or Colson Global, they will only offer you that, okay, ma'am, okay, Nancy, you can join our company. We have an immediate requirement. So they'll give you offer letter. Say, suppose if you have mailed your CV to 200 companies, okay, so minimum 30 to 40 companies will definitely reply back to your mail if you have prepared your resume the way I told you. If you're going to simply write, I'm a good carom player, or you have won singing competition, no company will entertain you. You have to clearly mention in your professional synopsis the contents which we have shared here. Only these contents if you mention. See, I'll show you. If you go to naukri.com and search plumbing design engineer jobs, just search plumbing design engineer jobs in Chennai or Bangalore, whichever location you want, you can just search. So let me just open naukri.com and page and show you how the job description will be. Okay, so you see here, one plumbing engineer position is there. See, what exactly they have mentioned. So the details they have not given. Let me check one more. Okay. See what exactly they are. These terms, you can just read the terms. What are the contents they are exactly asking? So what exactly the company is working on? So the exact things you will find in the internship which you will be learning. Okay. So wait, let me open one more. See, all these drawings, reading the drawings and designing plumbing system, mechanical system, electrical system. You should know, see, being a civil engineer, you cannot say that I know only civil part. You should know about HVAC also. You should know about electrical system also. Because once you are promoted as an MEP engineer, once you're promoted as a manager, that time you will have a responsibility to take care of all the departments. You cannot say that I am from civil, I am from mechanical, I know only this, I know only that. No, you should know everything. Okay. So you need to understand the importance. You should apply in a proper direction. Okay. So say suppose if you have applied, as I was telling, for 200 companies, if you have applied, minimum 30-40 companies will schedule an interview. If you can clear at least 10 to 15 company interviews, start working part-time with them. By the time you pass your engineering, minimum at least 10 to at least 3 to 4 company will definitely give you an offer letter to join the company. And what you can do, last month there was one student, he was from Delhi. He had completed HVAC training, heat, ventilation, air condition design training for mechanical, what we have. And he started applying for the companies in Dubai and Kuwait. Okay, he simply searched in Google the companies which are located in Dubai. He mailed his CV the way I told him. And he got a salary package, 4 lakhs. He got an offer of 4 lakhs per month salary package in Kuwait. And in Dubai, he got 2 lakhs package. I told him not to go to Dubai, go to Kuwait, because the salary is more and in Dubai is very expensive. Even if it is 2 lakhs, he won't be saving much there. Okay. So you can also apply for the companies. By the time you pass your engineering, you can start applying for abroad-based companies also. Okay, so what you need is exactly the skills. If you start building your skills, trust me, it will help you a lot. If you are going to simply blame your HOD or placement officer or your college that no core companies can coming to campus, so then it will not help you guys. So what you need to do is put efforts. Ask yourself, if tomorrow a core company comes to campus, how many of us are prepared to clear an interview? Ask yourself, do you have the knowledge what exactly, how to do the designing of plumbing system? I'll show you our previous batch, what we have conducted. So 7 p.m. plumbing batch. See, this is a batch from what we have from Ambedkar Institute of Technology and Anurag University, Hyderabad. So these are the students, they have given their feedback in plumbing internship. This we completed last month. Okay, I'll show you how the sessions are being conducted. I have taken the personal feedback from each and every student, because being a co-founder, for me, your satisfaction is my utmost priority, because students should be satisfied. And you can see here how the sessions are conducted. So see, we share the Zoom meeting link for daily session like this. After that, the session recording is given. It's uploaded in Drive, and Drive link will be shared to the students, so that if students miss out on any of the class, they can have the backup. Okay. So you can see in this way the sessions will be conducted. So we will be giving you a new group also will be created for you. Okay. Let me just create a new group. So for you, there is 8 p.m. plumbing SVC group I'll create. Those who are interested can just inform me. You'll be added to this group. Okay, if you're interested to join for the internship. And we have students from Pan India. Why we are conducting this internship is because not every student can actually Yeah. See, not every student can. So I'll just share this plumbing link. If you are interested, you can let me know. So you can join this group. If you, those who are interested, can join that group. I will be adding you to that 8 p.m. plumbing batch. So how to register for the program is, you can see here the students are registering. I was telling you here, see, if you want to do a plumbing design course, right? This we never started. We were not conducting internship earlier. We got this request from students only. You can check in Google how much will the plumbing course will cost. Okay. So go to MEP courses of any of the training institute. Okay. So go to plumbing here. Students only told me that, ma'am, we cannot pay 20,000, 30,000 in institutes because institutes are charging 20,000. See here, plumbing design course. Okay, 1 month course. Not every student can afford so much. So we started this program in minimum cost. So the fees for this internship is just 1,500. Okay. So all the students are there here. So they're registering. You can see Bangalore Institute of Technology, Civil Branch. So here you can see he's added to this 8 p.m. plumbing batch. This batch we have started last week. Some 8 days are over. So almost you can see around 98 participants are there. All these students are from Dhanan Sagar PA College. From across Pan India, there are students. Okay. So you can see here. So the session is conducted. And I'll be sharing you the session link, the live session link. Sir will be sharing you the recording of that session. Okay. So in this way, you will be getting the internship. So for you, we will have this 8 p.m. batch I have created here. Interested students can register. And how to register for the program is just share your details. That's it. Share your details in this group in the same format. Okay. Your name, your roll number, your college name, your department and topic plumbing design. And you can register and send your payment screenshot. Fees is just 1,500. This is the number which you're supposed to pay. Okay. I'll just mention the number. Don't worry. Send your screenshot. I'll add you to the group. We'll start a new batch for you if there are more than 30 people, because we need minimum 30 people to start the batch. Okay. So 9810188747. This is the number which you can pay to Google Pay or phone you can do. Okay. So we have our Facebook page also. See, there was one student called Irfan, New Horizon College. He's a student from New Horizon. He got placed in Siemens. Okay. So what we do is we help our students also for any vacancies coming up. I'll share you this Facebook page link. You can like our Facebook page for the job updates. You can read here. He was a part of our 3 days workshop in his campus, New Horizon College. We had conducted a 3 days hands-on workshop on HVAC system design. After completing, he got placed in this particular company. Okay. He asked me and also have told him, if any vacancies are there, please let me know. So he had updated one requirement. So what happens every time when our students or when we get the requirement, I cannot, you know, post it. So if I just search here, make HOD or civil HOD, you can just see here, there are so many civil HODs from various engineering colleges. So I cannot give them the, you know, HOD. So sometimes I share it with them on the face in this also. In Facebook or personal chat also, I just send them the requirement. See here, I had shared the requirement also. But every time I cannot post the requirement to the HODs. There are 200, 300 college HODs, so I cannot do that. So what I do, I update it in our Facebook page. Okay, so I'll share you the Facebook page link. So you can like that page for the job updates also. Okay, so any questions if you have, you can ask me now. I hope the session was informative, and all the best to all of you guys. So keep this PDF safe. Let me share you that PDF again for those who have joined late. Okay. Suppose in case if you want to do the registration and if there are 30 students from your college, because we had a mechanical batch also from your college. See here, SVCE batch was there. Okay, so 72 participants were there. You can see if I just search SVC here, all these students are from mechanical department, your college only. Okay, so he is Karthik. He is mechanical HOD's son, actually. He also registered. So this was for mechanical batch. This we had conducted for mechanical batch. Okay. For you also, we can conduct. And any questions you have, you ask me personally. So you can write down my number. I'll just share you the number here. So this is my number. You can take a screenshot of this. Okay. Any questions, if you have, guys, you can ask me now. So how to register is simple, guys. Just send your details in this group. Okay. Just send your details, your name, your roll number, and your college name, department, topic, mention it as plumbing design, and send your details. And this number, you can do the payment and send the screenshot in group. I will add you to the 8 p.m. batch. Okay. Thank you. Any questions now? So make sure you prepare your resume the way I told you. Okay. So I hope all of you will get into the core companies. Do not get influenced by the rumors that there are no jobs in core mechanical civil, join IT company. Ultimately, you will start getting frustrated even if you join later, because I have seen a lot of people coming from IT. They were working in IT field, later they came and they started their career again as a civil engineer fresher. So because jobs, money is not just important, guys. All that is important for us is your job satisfaction is also important. Okay. Any questions? That's it. So shall I end the session then? Any questions, ma'am, please? Vijay, Vignesh, please. Feedback link will be for the end of the session. Please wait. Okay. Any questions you have, guys, you can post it in the chat now. Or else I'll just wind up the session.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you so
much. Participants, if you have any doubt, you can post it in the chat box or you can unmute your mic and you can ask. There is no doubt, I think so. So I request Ms. Lokeshwari to for finally a department of civil engineering student to propose a lot of thanks. Lokeshwari, are you there?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Am I audible?
Yes.
No, you're audible.
Yes, sir. A warm and graceful afternoon to everyone present here. It's my great privilege to propose a vote of thanks for this technical talk. We would like to express our gratitude towards Mr. Dhiravya Balan sir and Mr. Vijay Vignesh sir for organizing such a wonderful technical talk. Also, thanks to our HOD Dr. Kumuda ma'am and principal sir for their continuous support and encouragement. On behalf of our college, SVC and civil department, a big special thanks to our speaker, Mr. Asif sir, for sharing his valuable knowledge on scope of plumbing design for civil engineers. Your speech really gave us deep insights into the topic and also revealed some interesting facts about what are MEP industries, HVAC, how to choose our own profile, plumbing design codes and standards, etc. We also gained an in-depth understanding of the topic. I'm pretty sure the precious knowledge that Asif sir gave us will definitely help us in future. I also thank Ms. Fahin ma'am for giving us a brief explanation about Princeton Smart Engineers, job requirements, internships, and step to get into core company. And you also enlightened us how to create a professional CV and resume. Thank you so much, ma'am. Once again, I would like to thank Asif sir and Ms. Fahin ma'am for taking out time from their busy schedule and enlightening us with their knowledge. Thank you so much. We are expecting more opportunities to learn. A heartfelt thanks to all the staff, students, and the participants who participated actively and paid attention. Thank you all once again.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much, sir. Also, I would like to thank HOD ma'am and also Vijay sir for organizing this event and making it successful. All the best to all the students. Take care.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much, both of you, to accept this invite. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, sir.